Hello everyone, my name is Tyler Krohn-Piatek from COLI at Canisius College. Today we are going to focus on using Microsoft Lens to create a PDF of handwritten notes or other documents. Microsoft Lens is a free mobile app that allows you to take pictures of physical documents and turn them into PDF files. You can also use previously taken photos and easily make multi-paged PDFs amongst other features. Note, this tutorial is mainly for iOS devices as Android devices can use the Google Drive app to create PDFs. I'm using an iPad, though the Microsoft Lens app is seemingly intended for smaller devices like smartphones. Therefore, be advised that certain controls may be placed differently. Let's get started. Obviously, you will need to download the Microsoft Lens app from the App Store. It may ask you to log in and if you want to check out any tutorials when you first download the app. You can safely ignore these. Once you get through the onboarding process, you can start your first scan. When scanning, try to do it in a relatively bright area. That being said, the Lens app does a great job even in low light conditions. Beginning your scan, you may see these orange lines. These lines are what the Lens app will capture automatically. Do not worry if it's not capturing the whole document. You can edit the capture area later. Just make sure that the rest of the document is still in the picture. Click on the white circle to take a scan. Mine is on the right-hand side of my screen, but that is because I'm using an iPad. The white circle should be at the bottom if you are using a smaller device. Once you tap the white circle, you will be sent to a screen similar to this. As you can see, the capture area is not exactly what I want to have captured. I can grab these white dots to rearrange the corners of the capture area. Or I can use these thin white circles to rearrange the entire side of the capture area. Once you're done rearranging your capture area, click on Confirm in the lower right corner. You'll get a processing icon pop up, but after that is done, you can edit your page. Let's look at what we can do. Add in the lower left corner, which looks like a simple camera with a plus sign, will allow me to add another page to my PDF. We basically follow the same steps as before to add another page. If you do add another image, it won't send you to the next screen automatically. Instead, you can take another picture quickly. When you are done adding more pages, find the orange button on the right with an arrow pointing to the right. It will also have the number of pages inside of a smaller black circle. Tap that to go back to the document editing window. Next is filters. If you are handing in handwritten homework or just want higher visibility writing, you can tap on filters and choose either document or black and white. Once you are done choosing a filter, you can tap on the document to get back to editing window. For multi-paged edits, you will have to make these edits to each page individually. Crop will let you crop out undesirable parts of your scan. Rotate will allow you to rotate your page. Ink will let you use your finger to draw things. And text will let you type things in. When you are done doing your edits, tap on the orange Done button in the lower right corner. You'll be taken to the Export To page. You can change the title by tapping on the name. I will change mine to Krohn-Piatek HW number 3, since I already have number 2 here. As an example, if you are unsure of what to call yours, either check the syllabus for the preferred naming convention or your instructor to see what the preferred naming convention is. I'll hit the blue Done button when I have finished. Next, I can choose where to put my document. I can add it to my library, save it to the device as a PDF in the files, send it to a number of Microsoft applications, including OneDrive, or send it as an attachment by email. If I tap More Apps, other applications that I can send it to and other options will appear. To make a PDF, tap on the PDF icon, and then tap on Phone Storage. From there, you will be able to tap on the PDF file you created. As you can see, I've got today, yesterday, and last week. Today is the files that I want, so I will tap on that. When you do that, you'll be able to see your PDF file. By clicking on the up arrow button in the upper right corner, you'll also be able to choose where to upload the PDF. Other options will also appear. I'll tap the upload file. I will slide from right to left on the ribbon of apps until I see Google Drive. It just says Drive here. Then I will tap on the Drive icon. Next, by looking at the bottom of the phone, I can tap on Select Folder to choose a folder to send it to. When I find the folder I want to save the PDF to, I will click on the Save Here button in the lower right corner. I can also set the sharing settings for this file right in this page here, but for right now, I'll leave it as Not Shared. In the upper right corner, Upload is no longer grayed out, but is instead a blue link. I'll tap that to begin the upload process. Finally, to make sure that the file has uploaded, I will open up Google Drive and check on the folder I uploaded to the file. After reloading it, the file is there. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, please contact us at helpdesk@canisius.edu. Thanks for watching and have a great rest of your day.